นี่ค่ะอาจารย์ค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ Good morning Sarah Good morning John
นี่ฮาวนี่ฮาวสวั
น
ส
ี่
ดี
ฮ
ค
า
่ะ
ว
อา
ส
จ
ว
า
ัส
รย
ด
์
ีค่ะคุณสลา
สวัสดีค่ะคุ
ส
ณ
ว
ห
ั
ญ
ส
ิง
ดี
ค
ค
่ะ
่ะ Okay Good morning John
สวัสดีครับ everybody
Good morning All right we could start 有没有人想问问题呢都没有人有问题 So far there are no questions
What about when you have your own discussion? Is there any question left for us to discuss?
Okay. 我们自己的讨论会有没有什么问题呢? There was one person who was not quite sure about every moment is conditioned. So if she sees someone on the street.And is attacked by the other person. So we talk about that about karma and vipaka for the different party. And so when we talk about upekkha, so somehow it's mixed, misunderstood as indifference. So that's his person, that's the person's vipaka.
The point is that trying to find out what is there in the book.And what about there now? See, suppose it's just what happened now, as she said. In order to understand the truth.
Ajahn,
please go.
Ajahn, let me translate the question first.
Yes,
I have not spoken the question yet, sorry. 问的问题是呢，很多人呢，关于平等心，或者是每一刻都是因缘和合呢，会误解成是不关我的事情或者是冷漠、哦、如果有人在路上被攻击了被攻击的人是他的果报那么去攻击的人在造业等等那这个对了解这是个人的因果业力的关系他就认为这是平等心这是一种误解那老师的刚刚的初步的回答是只是了解书上写什么那如果现在就发生了
Not having
yes,
heard about the teachings at all, what about the feeling at that moment? Should it be known, or should we try to understand what word is used?
那么在看到那个时候呢，其实什么在那里？比如说感受呢？感受那个时候我们看到的感受是什么？它需要被了解吗
？When one is not questioned, can one know that at that moment what is there?For example, is the feeling at that moment as well? At that very moment.
如果我们都没有问，如果我们从来没有去问过自己，提醒过自己什么在那里，我们会想过有什么在那里吗？比如说感受，在看到有人被攻击的时候，那个时候所谓的我们的感受呢是什么
？Do we have to find out what word?Is used for that feeling, or even there's no word at all. Feeling is there to be known, to understood, to be an understanding more and more.
那我们需要给感受一个名字吗？一定要知道名字才能知道什么是感受吗？其实是不需要名字的，那个时候感受就在那里。
So no matter in what language, it represents the reality right then to be understood, the nature of it as it's just is there by conditions.
所以以刚刚感受的例子而言，不管在那里的是什么法，它有它的本质，因缘条件升起的，它也会有它的因缘条件灭去的。
There must be different feelings for different person at all.Any moment, even at that very moment in such situation, different feeling by conditions. Why it not the same feeling?
那么每个人呢，在每个不同的时刻，一定都是不同的感受。即使是在刚刚描述的路上的，看到那个有人被攻击的时候，每个人都有感受，可能也不会一样的。
And at that very moment, there's not just feeling. There must be.Remembering too of that object as what it is.
那么在看到那个景象的时候呢，也不是只有看到的时候的感受，一定也有想运哦，想运记得那些被看到的是什么。
And there must be seeing and thinking, but thinking is not seeing. Should it be understood as it is?
那么在那一刻呢，一定也有演示经验呢，被看到的色尘，以及接下来思考着被看到的是什么。那这些需不需要被了解
？Looking for the word, what is that word? At moment of feeling such and such.
那还是只是在想着我们书本上学过的这个字或那个字而已。
That's why the study of reality to understand this moment is to understand what is there as it is one by one. Otherwise, there's no idea about it as it is conditioned, whatever is there.
那么我们学习佛法其实就是在学什么？就是在学现在在那里的是什么？一个，因为很多法，一个一个去了解。或者我们没有办法真的了解它的因缘生灭的本质。
So, the Buddha taught about studying Dhamma. It does mean studying the word, but Dhamma is there. So, study Dhamma is what is there now, cannot be known without the word of the Buddha. As it is, as not self, even such and such word.
当我们说读佛法，读佛法的时候，我们在研究的是现在在那里的实相，正在生灭，正在出现的。当然是需要透过佛陀的教导，佛陀的话，但是重点还是不能够只是停在文字上。
So now we are studying Dhamma or just understanding the word?
所以我们现在是真的要去了解法吗？还是只是在知道文字上的意思而已。
Otherwise, what the word is translated doesn't bring or lead to understand this moment as it is, as not self, Dhamma.
否则我们的讨论呢，就不会真的培养了解现在法出现的条件了。如果一直只是在文字上的思考。
So that's when begin to do study.Or to consider, or to reflect whether what is there now, the truth of it, what is it?
所以我们有真的准备好去所谓的思慧吗？去思考佛陀讲过的现在在那里的是什么？它的真相是什么？
This is the point of studying to understand what is there as it is.
这个就是所谓的去真的如实了知现在在那里的是什么。
Without the eye, can there be seeing right now?
没有眼睛，现在能够看吗？
If there is no seeing, can there be any feeling of that object?
如果从来没有去看，能够对被看到的产生感受吗？
And without seeing, can there be attachment of that object which is not seen? That's why everything comes from conditions.
如果没有去看的话，那个可以被看到的会成为贪爱的对象吗？所以是要条件的。
Talking about just one reality and understand what conditions that reality, or can it arise without conditions at all?
那么，不管在那里的是什么，我们也去思考，如果没有不同的各种条件，它能够在那里吗？
Does feeling right now arises from hearing or no hearing?
现在有因为听到什么而有产生什么样的感受吗？
So let's talk about a reality or what you take for a thing, whether it is conditioned or without condition.
嗯，所以我们来讨论那个被我们当成是某个人或某个东西的是什么。
This is the beginning of letting go, little by little, of wrong understanding of self taken from what is there, which is experience.
这个呢，是我们逐渐的降低哦，就是对我存在的邪见，有东西在那里的邪见，越来越了解法，我们都把法当成是人或东西，这件事情会逐渐的消除。
Is there still doubt about what is appearing is conditioned? What arises is conditioned.
对于现在升起灭去的这些法是有怀疑的吗？
不是。
啊，是。
是。对这个生起灭去的法呢，我们就是说没有，没有那种好像很清楚的这种怀疑的地方，好像应该是这样。但是我有一点不明白的是，就是说，这个佛法它最后的结果，它应该是说，是不是认为生命它是一种苦嘛？因为生命无常，所以它最终的结果是要，就是说。就是要离开生命了，或者是说就是说要这一点我有一点点总是，当然我觉得我能接受，但是总觉得好像那这个和那个神所倡导的就是要这个就是生命要在神里面，这个他们终极的目标有
好 OK 那
这个问题
Okay, this question may have been bothered Da Zhuang for a while. It's about the final result of studying Dharma. It's about realizing dukkha and realizing there's no worse to be alive, stay alive. There's no meaning. So it's about termination of life. So I think he is concerned about that.
The point, the final destination of studying, is that what you'd say? And what about...
Destination, Ajahn?
And what about this very moment? Is that not the point, the destination of understanding it as it is?
Mm-hmm. 那关于研读佛法最后到达的目的地的目的，现在呢就是了解现在这一刻。
Otherwise, what should be understood?
Uh-huh. 否则是什么要被了解呢？The concern is after understanding all the realities, it's the termination of life. And I think there's a concern of termination of life.
And what about now? No understanding now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
那现在有智慧在了解吗？
With our understanding of what is there now, can anyone reach that destination?
如果不能够了解现在什么在那里，又有谁能够真的抵达终点呢？
And isn't the destination?
There's no understanding.
Yes, please.
If there's no understanding now, how can there be any understanding of the end of life at all?
如果不能够了解现在这一刻，又怎么能够了解所谓生命的结束呢？
So one may think, oh, everything in life is.Dukkha unsatisfactory, not worth living, so it's better to end life. But this is not understanding this moment and what dukkha means.
所以当我们说呢，圣谛苦圣谛呢，活着在轮回中是苦的，那么最好是结束它这件事情。那其实是没有真正了解现在这一刻哦，以及什么叫做苦，苦的特征是什么。
Because if there's true understanding of reality now and how it's conditioned, there's no thought that at the end of this life, if this life is terminated or finished, that this will be the end of dukkha.
那么其实当思考的关注的兴趣的是现在这一刻呢，那么当然就可以了解这一刻的时候，也可以了解在生命结束的时候。Sarah, could you say the second part again? Sorry.
If there's understanding that the seeing now arises by conditions, there's the understanding that whatever citta arises, whatever reality arises, it has to be the same because it has to arise by conditions. So after the last moment of this life, the next moment must arise by conditions also.
那么了解这一刻是有因缘条件升起而且会灭去的，真正的了解呢，同样的就会了解在死亡的那一刻也是这样子，那么也可以了解在死亡那一刻呢，也是升起就是灭去的因缘生灭的法，那么下一刻也是这样子。
So someone may think about the termination of life, but with no understanding that while there are conditions for life to continue, while ignorance and attachment haven't been eradicated, life has to continue on from moment to moment, life to life, endlessly.
就当我们顾虑所谓生命会结束，如果佛法最后的终点，但是在那之前呢，只要还有不善的污染在，那么也就是说五蕴就还有条件在升起灭去，生命是持续的，所谓的生命也就是每一刻的法的生命，每一刻的经验一直在持续下去。
No one can stop life arising in any way, no matter what they think about or what action is taken, it's impossible to stop life because the conditions for life, the conditions for birth are clinging and ignorance.
那么只要五蕴还有条件生灭，没有人可以做任何事情来阻止它的升起灭去的，没有人可以采取任何行动不让生命，只要五蕴还有条件生灭的话。
And if there is no understanding of the reality of seeing now, the direct understanding of seeing, how is it possible for there to be the direct understanding of the arising and falling away of seeing? And if there's no direct understanding of the arising and falling away of seeing, how can there be the direct understanding of the unsatisfactoriness of seeing at this moment?
如果现在这一刻呢，不能够真的了解经验什么是眼识，怎么能够进一步去了解眼识是生起灭去的呢？如果不能够了解眼识是生起灭去的，又怎么能够进一步了解这个是会不满足的呢？
So when there is thinking about studying Dharma and the end of dukkha, it's like a fantasy story, imagining what it would be like not to have dukkha, but actually not understanding the reality now, which is dukkha.
所以如果只是想着生命就可以结束了，苦就可以结束，那只是一个幻想哦，并没有了解现在什么才是生命的本质是什么，就是法的生命而已。不过这个方向好像跟大壮问的有点点 OK。
没有，可以，应该我能理解。因为我想这样子理解，
你不是担心生命就停止了吗？你不是想要停止，你是担心停止。
不是说
OK。
我是想就是说佛，因为佛法它比这个神的那个，因为我们怎么讲，它应该是认为它是更究竟彻底嘛。那么这个我们现在也确实感觉到了， 但是他是不是说也在把人导向善嘛，是吧？先是就是说你必须具有善的品质，然后导向善就是说导向神性的一面，然后又在他的基础上进行解脱呢，或者智慧具足呢，应该是这样一种，好像是这样一种，我感觉啊是这样一种路子一样，好像。如果是说他没有，他确实是在导向善。当然有的可能他没有达到那么高的善，或者是说他只是说自己暂时解脱了，这个当然也是很好了。但是佛陀他能达到那么高的善，他是不是说他也完全具备了所谓的最高的那种神性嘛，是不是？然后他也具备了解脱的智慧。
啊，大壮也是一个问题哦。So regarding liberation,It's that cultivated on the basis of kusala. So because of cultivating kusala, and then there is the way leading to liberation.
I would like to ask Da Zhuang if he doesn't like the idea of cessation as a final term, a final destination.What would he like the final destination to be?
好，大壮，我们先回到一开始哦。或许我没有讲清楚你的问题，但是你记不记得我们其实长期以来常常在讨论，你觉得好像佛法到后来就不再出生了这件事情，其实是有一点点什么都没有了。那现在这样的问题是说，如果你觉得所谓的生命不再出生的这件事情好像不是那么的吸引人，那么你会希望生命怎么样呢？
其实呢，我们通过学习或者说对法的了解啊，我是认为因为本来也没有所谓的一个什么真实的真的我的存在，但是它生命的存在呢，它确实是起来了这么一种现象，这种现象我们把它叫做生命啊。那么佛法呢，我想佛陀他是要说明白苦啊，他是要说明白这个苦的、
大壮，你看你能不能直接回答这样的问题是说，如果你觉得佛法是关于最后不再出生的苦的停，就是不再轮回，没有条件再出生的，你如果觉得这样子有点点不吸引人，不能再出生，不能再去经验的，那你想要什么？你希望会怎么样？
好像没有希望怎么样。我只是觉得确实这个法的这个
大壮，我先把你的回答回给这样。大壮的 answer is really nothing particularly he wish for.
As Ajahn and Sarah have been pointing out, what we learn when we study the present moment reality is the unsatisfactory nature of realities.
那么就像老师跟 Sarah 刚刚提到的，我们去了解现在的法，其实就是在了解它的本质是不可能带来满足的。
And the escape from the conditioned and unsatisfactory nature of realities must involve something that is unconditioned.
Okay. 那么要从这个生灭的这样子的实相法里面脱离解脱出来，一定会牵扯到没有因缘生灭的。
So the nature of realities in samsara cannot be changed. The only escape from that is the escape from samsara completely.
那么在整个轮回中呢，这些法不断的生灭，这些法这件事情是不能够被改变的，那它又不能够带来满足，所以唯一的方法离开不满足就是离开轮回。
But to be quite frank, this doesn't reallyis not really a concern for us at the moment because we don't actually see conditioned realities as they are, as unsatisfactory. So we just want more of the same.
但是事实上，这件事情对我们来讲，对我们目前的程度来讲，还不是什么真正的顾虑，因为我们连现在法都不能够真的了解了，也不可能真的体会到这些法不会带来满足的本质这件事情。
And since we want more of the same, the idea of cessation is a problem for us.
那么对于那些呢，就是不再出生，会有顾虑的人呢，他们其实是想要更多。
But as understanding is developed, what seems a problem now, may no longer be seen as a problem. It may be seen as a solution.
那么对于智慧，在我们这个程度来讲呢，如果顾虑，生命停止不再出生事情是一个问题的话，对那些智慧已经累积到够高的人来这个问题，这是一个解答。
Because we are thinking about cessation from the perspective of a lot of ignorance and wrong view.
因为当我们想着生命停止不再出生的时候呢，我们是带着很深的无明跟贪爱在想着这个问题的。
So, the problem actually is too much thinking about something that we don't understand.
所以问题呢是来自于我们想太多，关于我们还不了解的事情，我们想的太多。
Instead, as Ajahn pointed out, it is better to have regard to what is appearing at the present moment and can be understood.
而不是像老师一直在提醒我们的，来了解现在正在出现的法，这个是一切的解答。
And without realizing it, the problem or the doubt is actually concerning oneself with most of our questions.
那么如果没有真的了解法这件事情，没有智慧的话，那么当然就是有怀疑以及顾虑自己的利益，什么对自己是好的。
For example, the first question about the indifferent feeling, meeting people in the street, and thinking aboutThe experience before, and whether wondering whether it's kusala or not, or what the reality is, we think we're considering dharma, but actually we're thinking about ourselves. What kind of feeling we had, wondering whether it was kusala or not, wishing to have more kusala.
那么比如说我们一开始提到的第一个例子哦，就是看到路上有人被攻击啊，那我们到底该不该帮忙呢？我们可能好像在顾虑的是善还是不善。那这个时候的感受是什么？我们其实只是在想着自己而已。
Or thinking about the future, wondering what it will be like when kusala has been developed, when it is the path, when it is the end of clinging, what the experience will be like. Again, we think.It's about the Dharma, but actually it's about me. What will happen to me? What will happen if there's no more experience for me? It's not the understanding of Dharma, which appears right now as Dharma, not self.
或者是当我们想着未来，当我们想着我们在培养善、累积善的时候呢，未来会发生什么事情？那么当正道的培养最后解脱了，那么不再出生的时候等等，其实我们想的都是我未来的我会经验什么事情，我们其实是在想着我可以得到什么或我会怎么样。
So that's why whatever the point or whatever the question or whatever the doubt, the truth has to come back to understanding what appears right nowSeeing now, thinking now, the feeling now as Dharma, in order to gradually let go the idea of I and my experience.
所以不论我们讨论什么的重点哦，那其实是回到了解现在这一刻，不管是在看、在听、在想什么样的感受，因为藉由了解现在这些法这件事情的了解本身，会逐渐的 降低对我存在对有东西的执取这样子的见解。
Whatever we read in the text or whatever detail we hear about the unconditioned reality or the cessation of conditioned realities without the understanding of Dharma now as Dharma, it can't be understood.
所以不论我们读到什么，不管是不生不灭的，好，或者是其他的主题，如果不能够真的了解现在的法这件事情，不能够了解，其实是不能够真的了解到底在讲什么。
It's just another example of how very deep and subtle the path is. And Loba would always like to find out about what happened yesterday or what the experience was or what it will be like in the future. Because just understanding or hearing about seeing now or visible object or hearing doesn't sound interesting at all for that Loba.
因为贪爱哦，所以我们可能会想着昨天的一个美好的经验，或者去期望未来明天可能有什么样的体验哦，而不是真的有兴趣现在那个去看的、去听的、去想的，因为这个显得很无聊。
But I think as the more understanding develops, the more the wholesome interest, the chanda takes more and more interest in reality at this moment.As not self, Dharma as Dharma, and studying Dharma just for the sake of understanding Dharma, not for finding out anything about past experience or what will happen in the future.
那么随着了解去研读现在的法智慧的累积呢，善欲也会累积增加，对现在到底是。什么法在那里？这件事情是真的开始有兴趣去了解，而不是当然还是会有贪爱去想要重复某个经验，或者是期望未来能够怎么样。但是善欲的增加会更有兴趣了解现在出现的法是什么，只是为了了解，而不是为了什么其他特别的事情，就是为了了解真相。
好，谢谢 Sarah， 谢谢 John， 谢谢老师。
At the end of the discussion last week, Dao Jun, you were asking about the three rounds beginning with Satchinyana, and we ran out of time, and you said you would like to discuss them more. I think it's also relevant to this topic.
那么上个星期呢，我们有讨论四圣谛的三转，那上次提到第一转。就是所谓的 Satchinyana， 就是在理智上理解真相是什么。那这个主题呢，跟现在在讨论的其实是相关的。
是。
Because talking firstly about Satchinyana, which is the very firm intellectual understanding of the Four Noble Truths, beginning with the understanding of dukkha.If this understanding about the realities now, seeing now, hearing now, each one as being impermanent and unsatisfactory, if that understanding is not firm enough, it cannot condition the direct understanding of the realities now, such as seeing or hearing, which is the Kichinyana, theSatipatthana understanding, the direct understanding of each reality and each of the Four Noble Truths.
那么在四圣谛的三转的第一转呢，是关于理智上的坚定的了解真相是什么。比如以第一圣谛来讲，在理智上有没有坚定的了解的信心，就是这些法，这些因缘和合的法，它是不可能带来满足的。那这样子的信心不坚定是不可能成为下一个第二转，就是所谓的 Kichinyana， 也就是所谓的四念住、直接经验，不管现在在出现的是眼识或者是耳识，直接经验法。
And if there is not the Kichinyana, the direct understanding of realities, the direct understanding of the path.
那么第二转呢，是关于已经能够有智慧，已经能够直接去经验法了，但是这个经验的了解的程度会逐渐的加深，逐渐的加深，成为第三转的因缘条件哦。那么第三转的话，就是所谓的 Katanyana， 它是所谓的内观智的阶段，它能够直接去了解了，就是在很高的内观智慧的阶段，直接了解这些法，快速的生灭，不可能真的带来满足，这也奠定了开悟的基础哦。
So whatever the topic, it has to begin with the very firm intellectual understanding of what is reality now, what is dukkha, what is the impermanence of the reality, and so on at this moment.
嗯哼，所以一切不管这三转是哪一转，它都跟现在出现的法有关。那我们现在在理智上是不是真的能够了解我们听到的跟现在的法是不是能够逐渐的去了解真的是这样子。
我想请问一下啊，就是心和那个心所，七个心所是一定是在一起的，是至少有七个嘛，是吧？那么就是说啊，心它因为七个心所一定是在的话，所以他那个就是爱取处受想思，就是他那个意图一定是在。那么心他一定没有，就是没有意图的时候，那就是说心从来不可能真正的纯净过，他出现的时候一定意图就在了。那么我就想问，这个他是谁先出现的？就是说譬如讲贪爱和这个心，
我们先确定刚刚那个主题已经讨论完了没？Before 大壮 raising a new question, let's make sure the subject was already finished. About a three round. 大壮
John might like to add more before it's finished.
Right. 大壮。那个你那个问题先等一下，我们刚刚那个三转还没有确定，先看看老师有没有补充什么。
好，谢谢。
John, would you like to add more about the three round of the Four Noble Truths? John, are you...
Forget to turn on. It's so very clear to me, but it depends on the listeners whether there is still some doubt or question.
好，那么刚刚 Sarah 的解说呢，老师说他听起来非常清楚，但是还是要看听众，其他的听众是不是没有怀疑了。有没有关于那三转都没有问题了吗？真的要第一转，我们真的只在第一转吗？大部分的我们
就是第一转就是那个苦，对苦的彻底的了解是吗？是这个意思啊？
理智上
这个我现在就是说
大壮，第一转是理智上的了解，
理智上的了解啊。
好，
苦然后是急，急就是贪爱，然后灭就是说知道了苦的本质是生灭法，它不可能有什么一个满足或者有一个我真实的实永存的永恒的我，所以它要灭，就是说它可以灭，
刚刚
这个三转吧，
刚刚解释的三转，第一转是理智上了解这四个甚至了吗？
这个就是说要那么很明确的说，实时在那个当中，经验过也是。我想问一下，他那个也就是说一个法出现的时候，他只是这个法，那他后面是什么在知道只是这个法？他那个是没有出现，但是他在，是不是？
好，大壮等一下，
这个问题。
I think the question is related to first round and that's conditioned the second round. And without directly experiencing the Dhamma. So Da Zhuang's question is about what experience directly know the Dhamma.
What is what? Please say it again.
The first round conditioned the second round. And yes. The second round is directly Satipatthana. So the question would be, what experience the Dhamma for the second round?
That's why we talk about the words of the teaching, just one word at a time, to really understand it. Because it's no me, not anyone at all. But what is that? See, without understanding, the intellectual understanding, the firm intellectual understanding of the path which is now understanding. Without understanding, there cannot be understanding of Dhamma at all. 嗯
哼，好，那刚刚的问题呢，是关于第一转呢，必须够坚定理智上，才会有第二转直接经验法的因缘条件哦。那到底是什么的经验法？所以老师才说，一开始我们就要很小心的知道，并没有我在经验，并不是我在经验。比如说去看的并不是我，那到底是什么在了解那个去看的呢？这个就是我们在讨论的第二转的四念住哦。
Now, no doubt about Dhamma. Whatever is there is conditioned to arise and appears in a false way. Is that not right understanding?
那么，如果能够其实理智上而已了解现在在那里的，不管是去看的、去听的等等不同的法，它升起就灭了。这样子难道不是正确的了解吗？
But we have to understand how many realities, so many conditioned by moment to moment. That's why the question is about what condition the certain truth, right? Or the path of understanding it, or the moment when it's there. It has to be very precise.
那么既然真相是就只是这些法在生命，那能够知道这件事情的因缘条件是什么？这个也是我们在讨论的第一转，然后能够变成第二转。
Without hearing, can there be even the intellect understanding of what is there now?So it depends on whether that is how much understanding is there about realities right now to condition sammasati, that which is aware of a reality, which is just like now, no matter when and where, it's just as it is.
那个因缘条件呢，如果没有听到佛陀的教导，有可能知道吗？是不可能知道的。即使听到佛陀的教导，关于什么是眼识，什么是声音，什么是色尘，但是这个的坚定的信心跟了解够不够深，能不能成为正念升起的因缘条件呢？
And even this level of understanding has to be firm enough to understand that the truth is just right now. Nobody can condition it to change to different reality.
即使只是第一转的这个了解的信心必须非常的坚定哦，非常坚定，现在在那里根本就没有谁在支配任何生命的法，这件事情必须有足够的信心。
Can panya, right understanding arise alone? There must be conditions for its arising as well.
智慧呢，正见它的升起，它是单独升起的吗？它的升起也必须有因缘条件。
So, when there are conditions for the right awareness to arise, it has to be panya, that which understands the different level of understanding, just intellectually or direct understanding.
所以，正见是那个带领的因缘条件的原因哦。如果这个正见智慧它本身不够坚定呢，那么正念是没有因缘条件升起的。
each reality has its own characteristic and its own function.
每个法都有自己的特征，自己的功能。
Even right now, there must be other realities besides right understanding as well.
即使是现在，一定有其他的法。即使正见有升起哦，也还是有其他的法。
For example, sati awareness of the word which is heard, the meaning of it, considering it, considering, reflecting to understand that word as it is, not self, little by little.
比如说，当智慧升起的时候呢，念这个心所也一定在那里，他记得这个这个。真相是什么？
Until right understanding condition, right direct awareness of a reality right now by conditions, panya, the intellectual level conditions that.
那么在理智上的阶段呢，智慧跟念都会累积哦，一直到他们有直接经验法的条件为止。
And when the direct awareness does not arise yet, who can make it arise? Impossible.But the understanding on and on, firm and firmer, condition the moment of direct awareness with right understanding, not without right understanding at all.
所以只要正念呢，也就是直接去觉知法这件事情呢的因缘条件还不具足的话，谁能让它升起呢？不可能。也只有透过正见去了解真相的加深的坚定的累积，才会具备这个条件。
We talk about direct awareness, which is there for panya to understand the object directly as it's heard and developed.
当我们讨论所谓的直接觉知呢，也就是正念呢，正念必须在那里去觉知法，那么智慧才能够去了解这个法的本质是什么。
Panya doesn't have the characteristic and function of awareness, and awareness doesn't have the function of panya. But when panya is enough to condition direct awareness, panya has to be there.
智慧并不能去觉知哦，那个是念心所的功能。念心所也不会去了解出现的法，它只是去觉知。但是要能够直接觉知法这件事情，必须是正见的智慧累积到了。有那样子的因缘条件的。
So it's the moment when panya understand the difference between intellectual understanding satyana and the satipatthana direct awareness kicayana。
那么在直接经验法的时候呢，智慧已经可以了解第一转跟第二转的差别了。它可以了解只是理智上的 satyana 跟后来直接经验法的第二转的。Kichanyana 它是不同的。
That's why Panya understands the moment without direct awareness and the moment with direct awareness. No, but we don't have to ask anyone. But the intellectual understanding is firm enough to condition the direct awareness, which appears as it is aware of a reality right then.
所以，第二转智慧。到了第二转的程度的时候，智慧也不用去问别人他到底在第几转，他其实因为已经有直接经验法，他可以了解第一转跟第二转的差别是什么了。
If there is no understanding of the characteristic of direct awareness, it is the second satyana, the patkityana of the noble truth, noble truth.
John, could you say that again?
When there is no understanding of the moment when awareness is there, it's impossible to be the path leading to understanding what is there as it is.
Okay. 那么，当没有智慧了解现在在那里的是什么，当然就不可能，因为这是在累积无明嘛，跟不善法，当然就不可能是在建立去了解去觉知法的道路哦。
Panya does not doubt, Panya is not aware, but Panya understands what is there when it is direct awareness.
那么智慧并不是以法，他不会去怀疑，但是智慧也不是觉知念这个心所，他也不会去觉知，但是当觉知的时候，他是在那里的，他是可以去了解法的。
That's why, according to what Buddha said, without the direct awareness and understanding, it's just the understanding of the word, intellectual understanding, but not the actual, the real one, the moment of awareness with understanding of what is there now. Because we can see, seeing sees, or seeing experience an object. But what about the understanding directly of seeing right now?
所以在第二转呢，或者是在四念住能够真的有正念去觉知，有正见智慧去了解这个法之前，我们当然是停在文字上、理智上去了解的阶段，就是演示是演示，演示去看，我们现在只是在文字上而已。
So what is there at moment of the second, from Satyayana to Kichayana? It has to be Sati, that which is aware. How can it be?Direct awareness with understanding, without intellectual understanding, impossible. That's why without the first, the intellectual understanding, there cannot be the second, the direct understanding of what is there. Not just intellectually.
那智慧的阶段呢，是不可能跳过去的、哦。第一转可以不要吗？直接有第二转吗？不可能的。第一转如果连这些法基本上的理智上的了解都完全不具备，信心也不到，也不是 很肯定，那怎么可能能够真的升起直接去觉知的这个法呢？
And by then, even Panya understand the characteristic of Sati, but it's so very weak when it's there. Anyone can realize the truth when it's there.So very weak of Panya.
那么即使呢是第一转已经有足够的因缘条件让第二转开始建立了，开始升起了，一开始也非常弱，一开始的觉知直接去经验法的那个正念也还非常的弱。
So it's long way from intellectual understanding Satyayana of the Four Noble Truths of all four to be the second truthKichayana, and how long will it take to realize the truth of it when it shows up as different realities one by one?
所以这是一条漫长的道路，正道是不是一触可及的哦？从第一转到第二转要多久？你日常了解到能够真的直接经验法这件事情要多久？就算直接经验法了。到他从微弱到能够建立越来越清楚，到能够到内观智慧，去经验这些法的生灭的危险，非常久。
If we don't talk about the truth of each reality as Sati and Panya and Vitaka and so on, how can there be Panya which understand that characteristic when it's there as direct awareness with understanding?
那么如果没有真的足够的坚定的理智上了解到底现在在那里的法是什么，当真的有觉知升起的时候，经验法的时候，智慧又怎么能够了解它是什么？
That's why one understands from hearing about what are there in a moment of listening and understanding from moment to moment.
所以这也是为什么我们在讨论现在一刻接着一刻在那里的到底是什么。
To know the truth that when it's not direct awareness with Panya, it cannot be taken for the path at all.
如果没有正念升起直接觉知法，那当然不可能是正道。
Is this the answer for the question?
这样子有没有回答问题了呢？就是第一转到第二转是谁在经验？是正念在觉知，智慧在了解，可以吗，大壮？
好，很好，谢谢，非常感谢老师。
Yes, appreciate very much.
And I think one more point is right from the very beginning, right from the first moments of considering about dharmas, the path has to be very gradual. The development of understanding has to be very gradual. So it's not like not understanding, then understanding all the time. But it has to be very gradual development of understanding right from the start.
那么 Sarah 补充，从一开始呢，我们就要了解，一开始这条正道的建立是缓慢的哦，他不可能说我本来不知道，那突然听听我就通通都知道了，或者是我就开始每一刻常常都知道了，不是这样子的。
So like now we begin to hear and begin to consider more about different dharmas, so that there are more moments of wise reflection, but there are also so many more moments of clinging and ignorance and doubt because those habits are so firmly entrenched.
那么就像现在啊，我们在讨论什么是法。那么我们奠定培养这个去思会去思考什么是法的条件，可是不代表我们就会一直在思考法，很自然的去思考法。大部分的时候我们还是在无明贪爱依法之中，在想的时候是不善的在想。
But as the wise considering and reflecting about dharmas becomes more and more of a habit, gradually there's less doubt andfirmer confidence that dharmas are anatta, that whatever arises is conditioned. So more and more wise considering very naturally.
所以在我们那么多的不善的习惯的力量之中呢，我们现在只是在讨论法，在慢慢培养去思慧的这个习惯，我们有没有思慧的习惯？这个已经成为一个力量了吗？去如理作意，现在在那里的法是什么
？And when that habit of wise considering and firmer and firmer intellectual understanding is developed, it can condition direct understanding with awareness of reality, as Ajahn mentioned, but.It's just for a moment and then gone. Afterwards, there may be doubt because it's so weak, or there may just be considering wisely. It doesn't mean that when it conditions moments of satipatthana, that then there is satipatthana all the time. It's not like that.
那么思慧这个习惯，也是说对现在什么法在那里的有兴趣的了解。这个逐渐的累积，逐渐的累积成为一个力量的时候呢，它才会是能够第二转直接经验法升起的因缘条件哦。但是即使是已经到了第二转，即使只是四念住开始了，那个一开始也是非常微弱的哦，它那么一刻就灭去了，它很快可能接着就是有疑法了。刚刚那个是什么？以及即使四念住开始发生了，不代表你就一直都在四念住里了。
And when the direct understanding of realities begins to arise and accumulate, so very, very little, and then a little more and a little more, it's still not firm or strong enough to condition the understanding of realities clearly, clear enough to be vipassana jnana.
那么即使四念住已经开始正在开始建立了，那一开始还是很弱很微弱，所以那个时候的累积是也是缓慢的，也不是那么常常频繁升起的。那当它逐渐累积到它真的能够法出现的很清楚，那个是已经开始准备进入第三阶段了，第三转了，就是内观智的阶段。在那之前第二阶段也是一条漫长的路。
And in between still conditions forMoments of wrong understanding, moments of doubt, moments of so much ignorance and attachment, because these states have been accumulated for so long, not eradicated at all.
所以它会这么慢，真正的重点是因为过去累积了太多的不善了，不管是贪爱啊、怀疑啊，各种不同的不善，它都有条件升起，所以不可能说一开始这边善或者是如理作意就可以非常具有因缘条件很强大的可以常常升起，不会是这样的。
But the more understanding of different realities, the more, first of all, the intellectual understanding develops more and more confidence in what is true and what is right at this moment. and then conditioning moments of direct understanding, again, gradually accumulating and developing firmer and firmer. But right from the beginning, it's gradual development of understanding.
所以一样哦，就是强调这条第一转本身到第二转，第一转本身就是一条漫长的道路。从一开始我们就要告诉，就要了解，我们对现在正在出现的法真的有兴趣吗？真的有足够的信心他们的本质是什么了吗？这个了解的累积。
And right from the very beginning, the object of the understanding, no matter it's just a little bit of intellectual understanding or it's highly developed, right up direct understanding, the object is still always the reality that is appearing now, this moment.
那么不管是刚开始在如理作意思会的对象跟智慧到高阶段的去了解的对象都一样哦，都是现在正在出现的法，比如眼识，并没有不同的对象。
So that's why we always talk about present realities, because from beginning to end, it is the development of understanding of present realities, dhammas as not self, anatta.
这就是我们一直在讨论的，就是现在出现的法。那么最重要的一个本质就是它是无我的，它不是谁的智慧。OK，
好，谢谢老师，谢谢 Sarah。
You always bring up very helpful points, Dajun, and so helpful for everyone. Thank you.
那最后就是谢谢你，谢谢你常常提出一些问题，对大家都是有注意的。
谢谢，谢谢。
有师兄，
啊，小胖，请说。
啊，萨瓦迪卡，塔纳扎和莎拉和大家打那个问题，就是关于第一转，因为我有在书中读到是它有十二个状态，所以第一转呢，我想知道是它要去第二转的时候，它是不是必须要知道那个苦集灭道四个，他才能萨底巴坦才会升起强的他的智慧的强度，才达到第二转，或者是还是只是知道第一个部分的图卡那个苦，就是可以达到第二个那个第二转这样子。
第二转的图卡，那其他的 truth 还在第一转吗？
对呀，所以我想知道这一点
okay, okay.
它是全部的要知道的吗？还是一个一个的知道来？
The question is about when we talk about the first round and the second round of the Four Noble Truths. So when first round condition the second round, does that mean the Four Noble Truths are both fully understood on the first round to condition the second round, or somehow the FourNoble truth, the different noble truths can have its own first round and then second round.
What is the first round again? The first round of the four noble truths. So what are the four one? What we start with, the first one.
那小范，第一转是什么意思？我们再来讨论一下，是哪四个圣地的第一转？
To be conditioned for the second round or the Satyana.
比如是苦。
Example, the first round of Dukkha Arya Satya.
Yes, but what is Dukkha? It has to be very precise. Is this moment Dukkha?
那什么是苦呢？要很精准哦。这一刻是不是苦？小范，你的问题是我如果不了解第三转的，我如果不了解第三圣地涅槃，我可不可以继续到第二转，对不对？第一圣地。
对对对。
OK. But I'm confused if I don't know the third noble truth. I don't know anything about the nirvana. Can I still condition? do the second round of the First Noble Truth or the path, even without knowing what the Nibbana is.
Okay. If there's no understanding of the Noble Truth or Four, beginning with the first one, if we don't have clear understanding of it, can it condition the second, the Satyayana and the Kittayana and then Katayana? So now we have to understand by questioning whether we have clear understanding, firm confidence of the First Noble Truth or not yet.
老师这边是先说好，如果对四个圣谛都没有第一转的足够的清楚了解，能够会有第二转去了解这四个圣谛吗？那如果以第一圣谛来讲，第一圣谛已经清楚了解了吗？第一转。
So we start to think about the First Noble Truth in order to understand whether we have clear and firm understanding of it or not yet.
所以我们先从第一圣谛的第一转先确定我们是不是真的清楚了解了。
Is seeing now dukkha?
现在的眼识是不是有苦的特征呢？
有。
Yes.
Is thinking now dukkha?
那思考呢？
有。
Yes,
it's all conditioned dhamma, which is now appearing one by one. Dukkha.
那现在一个接着一个生灭的因缘生灭的，他们是 dukkha 吗？
Why it is dukkha?
是 and yes, and why is 为什么它是 dukkha?
因为它是生起灭去不存在的。
Because it arises and falls, where it's not there anymore.
It's firm now. The seeing now is dukkha.
那现在很坚定的吗？眼识是 dukkha。
很坚定，在听这一刻很坚定。
Now this moment is firm.
Okay, why it is dukkha?
那为什么它是 dukkha? 为什么是苦？老师等又问了一次，为什么它是苦？
Not just believe, but to really understand the dukkha of it.
不是只是去相信说是苦，而是真的了解它为什么是苦。
对，是的。
Yes.
So why is dukkha?
那为什么呢？为什么是苦？为什么眼识是苦？
因为它一直在生灭。
Because it's arise and fall away, arise and fall away.
Never to return. But is that clinging to seeing now?
那他一直生灭哦，那现在有没有对他的执取？
现在没有。
No clinging now.
No clinging to it, to seeing right now. Oh,
没有吗？
That is clinging.
现在没有对眼识执取吗？
没有，也许是有，可是不知道。可是现在呢，感觉到没有。
Maybe there is clinging, but there's no notice or no sense there is clinging.
So that is not firm intellectual understanding. Even that.
所以这表示对第一圣谛的了解还没有坚定，信心还不够坚定。
So understanding reality, especially the Ariya Satta, is not very easy and not superficial at all. It has to be the moment of beginning to think about the truth. So what's the use of that which is conditioned to arise? No one and nothing at all. Very, so, very short and then gone, never to return again from moment to moment in samsara, long, long time ago, up to now, and then it go on like this. So no one, so what's the use of that which is conditioned to arise and fall away in split seconds? Is it not dukkha in the sense that it is unsatisfactory?
Mm-hmm. 那么对四圣谛的了解呢，四圣谛是很深奥的，不是只是表面上的文字的了解。那么以现在的苦圣谛来讲，那升起就灭去了，升起就灭去了，有什么用呢？那这本身不就是一个不可能带来满足吗？那其实我们对这个生灭还是很执取的。
And this is the point of study on and on, more and more about the truth of this moment.To see the dukkha of what is there from moment to moment.
嗯，那么这也是我们学着在了解的一刻接着一刻哦，在那里的生灭的其实是有苦的特征的。
It's not just taking it for granted. Okay, it's dukkha, then finish. Or that is not like that. It has to be firm and firm with confidence of the truth in order to see the dukkha.
嗯。所以第一转呢，不是只有说哦苦圣谛了解了哦苦圣谛生老病死等等，而是真的越来越加深它为什么是苦，每一刻的生灭的法怎么可能带来满足？这个信心有加深吗
？And it is not firm enough at all just to think that it's dukkha, because even in the Buddha's time, when people ask the monk, "Why do you be monk in Dhamma Vinaya?" he said.Just to develop, to understand, or to see, to experience dukkha.
嗯，那么对法的了解呢？不是那么对圣谛的了解，不是真的那么容易哦。即使在佛陀时期，有出家的加入僧团的，他们被问为什么加入的时候，他说他来经验苦，体验苦。
Even the purpose of studying or becoming a monk, it has to be so very firm. For what?Just to understand the truth, the absolute truth, that which is said just very shortly and then gone, no one and nothing anymore left, and never to return.
嗯，那么要成为真正的准备好出家了，是不是真的已经只想了解真相是什么了？去了解现在在那里的他生灭是不值得执取的。
So does anyone experience the dukkha now?
那现在有人
falling away of the truth.
现在有人经验了苦圣谛吗？苦的特征了吗
？And what are there in the world? In what are there today? Must be all dukkhas. Who experienced that?
今天在那里的不管是什么，一定都是苦圣谛哦，都有苦的特征。
So it's not just a matter or subject to talk about, but it to realize the truth of it.
嗯，所以呢，不是只是去讨论文字，而是真的真的去了解它这个文字背后真相的意义是什么。
Otherwise, how can one respect the great virtues of the Buddha, who taught about the truth that he had experienced directly?
或者怎么能够真的了解佛陀自己亲身体证的真相是什么
？And since the absolute truth is there now, it can be known, but not by ignorance and not firm confidence of the Four Noble Truths.
那么真相现在就在这里哦，但是它并不是被无明来了解的。
That's why we can say another way.Study the teachings just to understand the dukkha of whatever is there now.
嗯，所以我们也可以这么讲，研读佛法就是要去了解现在在那里的不管是什么，是有苦的特征的。
And it can be the beginning of understanding the profoundness, the subtlety, the deep truth there now, which keep on arising and falling away from one moment to another moment.No one there at all.
嗯，所以其实整个道路的建立也是逐渐的了解，不管在那里的是什么，它的生灭的本质，它的不能带来满足的特征。
Without this first this purpose, they are conditioned to think about other things. That's why in the teachings, it's all about ehipasiko, just come here and look and think and study what is there now.
嗯哼，那么如果不是这样子呢？如果这个不是是真正的核心目标，他就会有去想着其他事情的因缘条件，而不是只是啊来这里做这里，所有的其实所有的目的都只是为了了解现在正在生命的法。
Where are you going around now? Not to understand what is there very close, but to many, many things around by thinking about it all the time.
嗯，所以不管你在哪里，或者是你要去哪里，如果没有这样子的一个你的核心的要的是什么，其实你就会去想着别的。
And nothing can condition direct awareness of the truth of what is now appearing without the teachings of the Buddha.
没有佛陀的教导，当然不可能有条件去了解现在的生灭的法。
That's why each of his words of truth lead to understand this moment. It doesn't go astray.
所以他的教导都是成为了解现在这一刻真相的因缘条件了。
So what about the first noble truth? Is it easy to experience? There must be understanding, very firm confidence to condition direct awareness of what is there now. Without these words, no moment of direct awareness and beginning to study and develop the understanding of the truth of it, but actually no one there at all.
所以关于第一圣地哦，是强调的还是现在的第一转的信心足够了吗？或者是不会真的进一步去了解法是什么？
That's right, we have to have clear understanding of the intellect understanding, the satyayana of the truth, all for truth, absolute truth.
所以我们在第一段理智上 的了解要够坚定，四个圣地都要够坚定。
If there is no dukkha, how can be the end of dukkha?
那么如果没有苦，又怎么会有苦最后的结束呢？
And people might think that it's necessary or it's the best thing to experience nibbana.What about that? It's not here. When this moment is not understood clearly, how can there be the understanding of just the word about it, about that word Nibbana, the end of samsara?
所以有些人可能会去讨论着涅槃哦，那个其实现在并没有出现的涅槃。那如果没有真的了解现在生灭的，其实是没有条件去了解那个不生不灭的。
As much as we can have just a little understanding about Nibbana is that it's not whatever is there now, not seeing, hearing, thinking, the arising and falling of what is there now. But it's quite different. That's why it's not citta, not jetasika, not rupa.
那第三圣地呢，涅槃呢，它现在不在这里。现在在这里的像眼识啊、耳识啊、去想啊、感受，但是涅槃非常不同于这些现在正在出现、正在生灭的法。
Can the reality which cannot understanding anything, ignorance, understand whatever is there now as it is?
那么现在在那里的真相，不管是什么样生灭的法，当然不是由无明，无明能够了解吗？不可能。
So how can ignorance and attachment understand Nibbana?
所以无明跟贪爱是不可能了解涅槃的。
And understanding does not belong to anyone. It's no one. It's conditioned to arise.
去了解的智慧也是无我的，不属于谁的，它有因缘条件生灭的。
From in the past, get close to hear the teachings, and that must be right.Wise attention to the word which heard, so that there can be the understanding of the truth, to be intellect understanding, to develop on to the understanding and realization of the noble truth.
所以还是回到智慧正确的培养的因缘条件呢，闻慧如理作意的思慧，现在正在出现的法的累积，智慧才能逐渐的累积。
So all depends on this moment understanding of ignorance and attachment.
那要所以都是看现在这一刻嘛，一刻接着一刻，到底出现的是不善法还是有智慧呢？
And what can eradicate ignorance and attachment? No reality at all, only understanding little by little.
那么是什么可以根除无明贪爱呢？就是逐渐累积的智慧。
So the first truth is not far away, it's now at this very moment hidden.
所以第一圣谛呢，并没有在很远的地方，就在现在，只是被掩藏起来了。
So imagine the darkness of ignorance, not understand the truth of anything at all, from birth to death, from life to life.
所以想象我们在多深的无明、多深的黑暗里。
Without the light, the word of the enlightened one, how can there be a little understanding and a little understanding of the truth? Because there is the truth all there of different realities conditioned.
如果不是因为佛陀的开悟，又有什么样的那样子的光能够让我们知道我们在黑暗里呢？真相就在这里，整天就在这里哦，可是都不知道。
That's why usually one might think about understanding, right understanding. What about ignorance? How much it has been accumulated?
我们可能都在讨论智慧，智慧。那无明呢？我们知道无明有多深吗
？And from hearing, considering.Is it enough to condition the second understanding, the Satyana and the Kittayana, before it can be Katayana?
所以在没有足够的累积每个阶段的因缘条件之前，不可能跳到下一个第二转或第三转了。
So, is there any question about the First Noble Truth?
那么对第一圣谛有没有疑问呢？
It's covered up the arising and falling away of what is there now, from moment to moment.
一刻接着一刻的生灭的真相被掩盖住了。
So how long will it take to understand the truth of it?
那要了解真相要多久呢？
Depending on many conditions too, like chanda, interest.To understand the truth, because one lives in the world of ignorance, or life, many lives ago and now and future. See, is it better to understand it?
那么
Not to
要多久呢
？Understanding.
要多久？其实有一个因素是相关的，就是那个真的有兴趣，那个善欲，真的想要了解现在的法。真的想要了解真相，这个会是因素之一哦。
What is there now? Or what are there in a moment?
现在什么在那里呢？或者在一刻里有哪些呢？有什么呢
？Unknown and gone, unknowingly, all the time.
不知道灭了，不知道灭了，一直都不知道。
So respect the three gems, the Buddha and the Dhamma and the Sangha.
所以我们知道我们有多深，我们也能更礼敬三宝。
Not by recite the word, but understanding the truth of each word very carefully, deeply, deeper and deeper.
不是只是引用他们佛陀说过的话，保存下来的话，而是真的越来越深的了解这些话的意义是什么。
By then, one understands who is the Buddha and pay respect to the great virtues, not just by flowers or candle.
那么也只有真正了解的佛陀的教导，那个才是真正的在礼敬佛陀，而不是透过花点香。
But by understanding each moment of the truth right now.
而是透过他的教导能够了解真相，这是最真正的礼敬佛陀。
谢谢老师，我听到老师这么解释，就更加坚定是那个第一转啊，也是没那么简单，还不要讲到第一转的极灭道，只是第一转的苦的这么难了，何谈到第二转？所以最重要的就是现在这一刻呢，我们就必须最珍贵、最为重要了解，就是现在这一刻。所以很感恩老师的教导啊，谢谢考坤卡。
Really sincerely appreciate John's explanation. So I understand, not talking about the second round, even the first round, even the first noble truth is not really intellectually understood enough. So forget about second round. And
this is the letting go of attachment to what you would like to have such understanding of this and that, all by conditions.
那么这也是一种舍离放掉，想要更进一步更快的达成了解这个了解那个。
And I was just going to make a short comment that Panya, as we've discussed before in other contexts, Panya develops in its own way, and this there will be variations from one individual to another as to what this means.
嗯哼，那么智慧的建立呢，其实是随着不同的人会不同的状况。
For example, when it comes to the three characteristics of anicca, dukkha, anatta, it depends on an individual's accumulated tendencies and the development of panya in the past as to which characteristic will appear more often than the other two.
嗯哼，那么比如说法的无常、苦跟无我的特征呢，在开悟的时候呢，是哪一个成为被了解的对象？其实跟每个人过去智慧的累积、每个人的累积的习性是不一样的。
We can just leave panya to develop appropriately, without having to think about the order in which it will.Come to understand the different realities and truths.
也就是说呢，每个人都不一样，我们就把它就留给智慧去做吧。智慧自己会去升起、了解、累积。那至于是了解无常、苦或无我，这个让智慧去做。